Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.1, Problem 8. This is Section 5.1, Problem 8, and it says, if Jim invests $1,400 at 6% compounded annually, how much will he have in 7 years? So because the question mentions the type of compounding involved, that's telling me that I need to use the compound interest formula as opposed to the simple interest formula. In this section, it has to be one of those two. So the compound interest formula is A equals P times in parentheses 1 plus R over M to the M times T. So now we'll fill that in. Now, A is the final amount. We don't know what the final amount is, so that will stay our variable. The 1,400 is what is invested now. That's P, the initial investment or principal. So as I fill in the formula, I get A equals P is 1,400 times the parentheses. In the parentheses, I have 1 plus R is for rate as a decimal. Now, this problem says 6%. So as a decimal, 6% is 0.06. Remember, it has to be as a decimal. Over M. M is the number of times compounded per year. So this problem says annually, so M is 1. They compound once per year. I close the parentheses. And the exponent is M times T. So M again is 1 for the annual compounding, times T is 7 because the problem says 7 years. T is the amount of time in years. And now I start the computation. I filled in the formula. The formula has some parentheses. Any type of math, you need to do the work in parentheses first. So the next step in the process is going to have A equals 1,400 times. Now in parentheses, I have 1 plus 0.06 divided by 1. Now, you're supposed to do the division first. 0.06 divided by 1, of course, is 0.06. And you're going to take that answer of 0.06, and you're adding 1 to it, 1 plus 0.06. I feel that I can do all the parentheses in one shot. In the parentheses, I have 1.06. And outside the parentheses, I have an exponent of 7. Again, 1 times 7, I have to figure out, which, of course, is 7. So now I have 1,400 times 1.06 to the 7th power. And again, there is a multiplication of 1,400 times the 1.06, and there's 1.06 to the 7th power, an exponent also. You have to do the exponent first. That's the rule. You have to. So A equals 1,400 times whatever I get when I do 1.06 to the 7th power. And again, it's not 1.06 times 7. It's 1.06 times 1.06 times 1.06 7 times. So with the calculator, you want to enter the base of 1.06. Use your exponent button, which on my calculator looks like x to the y power, and then enter the exponent of 7. And on some calculators, it would be the base of 1.06. The exponent button looks like an arrow that points up. They call it a caret. And then you enter the exponent. This exponent's small enough, if you have a basic function calculator, you could actually enter the 1.067 times. But that'd be more work than it's worth. I'm going to use the exponent button. So my calculator, 1.06, exponent button, 7 equals. And the answer I get is 1.50363.0259. And again, I'm going to leave all those decimals in for now, and I'm just going to round it to two places at the very end. So now my formula is A equals 1,400 times 1.50363.0259. So the decimal value of the 1.50 whatever is on the screen of my calculator still. So I'm just going to leave it there and do times the 1,400. Why enter it again? There's no need for that. So the number on the screen times 1,400 equals. So I get an answer that A equals 2105.082363. Now, because this answer is money, I don't need that many places after the decimal, six positions after the decimal point. There's no use for that. So what I'm going to do is round it to two places. It'll tell me how many cents. So as I look past the decimal, I have 082, then some other stuff that doesn't even matter. The 082 is not big enough to make it 09 or 9 cents, so it's just going to get chopped off at 08. So my final answer is $2,105 and 8 cents. So if this person, Jim, invests $1,400 now at 6% compounded annually, after 7 years, the amount of money he'll have is $2,105.08.